Shakes my body and it destroys my heart and kills my spirit to hear words and titles given to me while I am presented to speak about the best of creation. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. When we come to him, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we have to throw away all of our knowledge. We have to throw away all of our pride. And we have to come to him with nothingness save for our love for him. And if I am to speak about the most perfect human being, I think I would be at my best if I consider myself as I am the most imperfect human being. As much as I would have of imperfection, I would be able to speak about his perfection. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help me realize that state of imperfection which I truly have, and I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help me rid myself of my ego, my pride, of my knowledge, and of everything that I claim to have or people claim for me to have. There's a verse in the Quran that scares when people are praised and they become silent. وَيُحِبُّونَ أَن يُحْمَدُوا بِمَا لَمْ يَفْعَلُوا فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّهُمْ بِمَفَازَةٍ مِّنَ الْعَذَابِ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Those who like to be praised for things they haven't done, don't think they are far-fetched from punishment, and for them indeed there is severe torment. I seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save me from the consequences of any claims, and I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make me realize my shortcomings and deficiencies. As my dear brothers and sisters, or let me call you all lovers of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, from all trades, from all walks of life, men and women, elders and children, Muslims and non-Muslims, we are all standing at his feet, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Not because he is the best of creation, but because he is the creation itself. Not because he was a prophet only, but prophethood was summed up in him. Not because he was a perfect man, but because perfection was him, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I know that I'm allotted 20 minutes, and there is a lot to say about him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I'm sure speakers, ulama, and much more eloquent and good-hearted people before me, Muslims and non-Muslims alike, expressed their love for him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and the respect, and enlightened your heart and your mind with a lot of information. I don't know what to say in 20 minutes, if there's anything to say about a man who engaged and busied all nations throughout the world for centuries and for centuries to come. 20 minutes or 20 years or 20 centuries or even 20 Google years seem all short if we are to speak about him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. If I am to speak about my own shortcomings, about my own imperfection, I would need much more than that time. So imagine now speaking about him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So allow me in the remaining few minutes to get out of my state and turn to him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, speaking on behalf of myself, addressing him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in person if he permits me. When we turn from the prayer, which takes few minutes, in which we are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we turn from the prayer to the dunya, to real life, to the world. People don't realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to turn from His presence to another presence. It is the presence of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Since we are unable to absorb the divine transcendence on ourselves, on our hearts, and on our souls, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us an opportunity to sit with another presence that reflected the divine presence on the face of the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to sit for all of our life at the feet of our beloved, our master, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, to prepare us for the divine presence. To be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a few minutes takes a lot of effort and a lot of struggle. We turn, we say, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Turn to the dunya. But before we turn to the dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us during our prayer that the best of this dunya is our master, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So we turn from the divine presence to the Muhammadan presence when we say, assalamu alayka ayyuha an-nabiyyu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. That is the key point in changing positions, turning from the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of the prayer to be in the presence of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam for the rest of our time, for the rest of our life, until another prayer time is due. This conversation with him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, assalamu alayka ayyuha an-nabi, should be ongoing, addressing him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and talking to him. If I am to speak to him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, I would say, O Messenger of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasul Allah, Ya Habib Allah, Most Beloved of Allah, we have come to you. We have come on the occasion of your birth. O Messenger of Allah, we have come to you, people from various backgrounds, with all of our shortcomings, lack of love, lack of following, lack of practice. Yet there is something that brings us all together in front of you, O Messenger of Allah. It is that we all love you. We all love you, O Messenger of Allah. Yet we bring in front of us not much action, not much practice. We bring in front of us to sit with you all the challenges that we are facing in our life. We are so much far away from your sunnah. However could we, dear brothers and sisters, qualify to sit in front of him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? O Messenger of Allah, we need your shafa'ah. And I'm speaking on behalf of everyone. We need his shafa'ah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam deena. This day have I perfected for you your religion, completed for you my favor, and selected for you Islam as a religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used two different terms referring to Islam and ni'mah. Al-yawma akmaltu. This day have I perfected. When talking about deen, deen is perfect. There is nothing to add to it. Yet, when talking about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, and completed for you my favor, my bounty. Ni'mah here is a reference to the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. It is one of his titles. When this ni'mah that is now complete will be perfect, it is when we are qualified for his shafa'ah on the Day of Judgment. Then the ni'mah of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and the divine favors upon us will be perfect. They are complete with his message, but will be perfect inshallah with his shafa'ah on the Day of Judgment. Yet, dear brothers and sisters, celebrating the mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and returning home to eat some food is not a celebration. If we love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have to follow him. If we love him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we have to understand his maqam. And understanding his maqam, his rank, takes some reading and studying his life, practicing his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The best people who understand him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are not the ones who only studied his seerah, because several orientalists did and many non-Muslims read about his life sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. But it is the ones who practice his sunnah, follow his guidance. There are amongst us people who consider themselves non-Muslims. And I consider it my obligation, as I know that they have a lot of love for this man, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I know that they have a lot of respect for him, his achievements, his personality, from different aspects than Muslims. But I would like to take this opportunity and seize this chance of you being here in this blessed gathering that you may take shahada. Do we have any non-Muslims amongst us here? If we have any non-Muslims amongst us here, you should understand that this is an opportunity. And in the famous hadith of Sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari, and this applies on all of us, even Muslims, and it applies actually perfectly on me, there would be a group of people sitting, يَتَعَاقَبُونَ فِيكُمْ مَلَائِكَةٌ بِالْلَّيْلِ وَمَلَائِكَةٌ بِالنَّهَارِ. Famous hadith, I'm going to translate in the English language. There come to you angels during the daytime and angels during the night time, and they meet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks them, and he is already aware of what they are carrying. How did you leave my servant? We left them praising you, glorifying you. Have they seen me? Nay, they haven't seen you. What if they see me? They would praise you more, glorify you more, and worship you more. What are they asking for? They are asking for Al-Jannah, heaven, paradise. Have they seen it? Nay, they haven't seen it. What if they see it? Or what if they saw it? They would be more eager to worship you and ask for it. O angels, be my witnesses that I have forgiven them. Be my witnesses that I have forgiven them. They have come only for the sake of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praising him, glorifying him, coming together for the sake of Allah in such a blessed gathering like this. Yet the angels, being precise in their reports, they say إِنَّ فِيهِمْ فُلَانًا لَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ. There is amongst them one person who is not one of them. He happened to be there. He happened to be there. Any non-Muslim who happened to be here, come forward please. Come forward and take shahada. There is amongst them someone who is not one of them. He happened to be there. Either out of curiosity or being brought by a friend, a classmate, or just maybe an informer to another party like the angels, but on the other side. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هُمُ الْقَوْمُ لَا يَشْقَى بِهِمْ جَلِيسُهُمْ. They are the people, whoever sits with them will never be under distress. Whoever sits with these people will be given salvation. Whoever sits with these people will be given success. This is why, dear brothers and sisters, coming to such gatherings, celebrating the mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down upon humanity, is of a great importance to all of us. Because we go back in life and we want to improve ourselves. It's a common complaint. Iman is in our heart. Love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love for His Messenger is all in our hearts. Yet, we have no ability to work better. We are weak in the field of practice, especially when confronted by the temptations of the dunya and the challenges of this materialistic life. This is why, my dear brothers and sisters, I want all of us to go home and start some serious work. Start some serious work on ourselves, promoting this love in our hearts for Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Attending study circles on His life, on His attributes, on His character. Getting around the people who do dhikr and make mention of Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us only in as much as we love Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to understand Him and to love Him and to follow Him. And He made it very clear in Al-Quran Al-Kareem in various verses. Probably one of the clearest of them is قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Say, if you love Allah, then follow me. Say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you love Allah, and I would say this to you all, if you love Allah, then know that there is no other channel to reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala different from the channel of the Messenger of Allah and the best of creation, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. وَأَنْتَ بَابُ اللَّهِ أَيُّ امْرِئٍ أَتَاهُ مِنْ غَيْرِكَ لَا يَدْخُلُ. You are the door to Allah. Whoever enters to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through any other channel will not be admitted. وَأَنْتَ بَابُ اللَّهِ أَيُّ امْرِئٍ أَتَاهُ مِنْ غَيْرِكَ لَا يَدْخُلُ. Whether it is heaven that you want, then you have to believe in Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and His message. Or you want just prosperity in life, and you want to open your hands and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for rizq, for ilm, for knowledge, for provision, whatever you want. Everything you want comes through Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Him saying, رَبُّ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ فَاتَّخِذْهُ وَكِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord of the East and the Lord of the West. There is no other God than Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So talking to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give Him authority to manage the world on your behalf. فَاتَّخِذْهُ وَكِيلًا. He is sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the door to the iman, to the success that we may get on the day of judgment. But not only that, He is the door to every bounty and every favor that we may get, even in terms of rizq, ilm, success, dunya wise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arranged the world that He wants all of us, believers, unbelievers, all human beings, to circumambulate this figure, this marvel in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected the human race. In logic, they say that a class may be seen in one individual. You might have a class and several individuals are imperfect according to the definition of the class. But if one individual is perfect, then the definition of the class is perfect. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam according to his image. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted perfection to be manifested in the human race, in mankind. But we look at this perfection, and I'm not talking here about the best of molds, of which the verse لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ loudly speaks, but rather of the inner perfection that is culminated in the recognition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the only God, in the obedience and the following of God's instructions, or as they say in Christianity, God's will on the earth. When we talk about this perfection, we see that all of the examples on the face of the earth are imperfect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected the human race, and this perfection is very manifest in Him sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. This is why He was a perfect human being. Now that you want to be perfect, of course, then you have to follow His footsteps. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves human beings, and He says yuhibbuhum. But what He loves in human beings is their humanness. Adamiya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves their Adamiya. So in as much as you're close to the perfect Adam, you will be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another way, in as much as you're close to Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, you will be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You love Him more, Allah loves you more. I want you all, dear brothers and sisters, to repeat with me, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. All together. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. محمد رسول الله. محمد رسول الله. Say it all together, especially our non-Muslim guests here. Where is the Reverend Bishop? Has he run away? I can't see him. He must have run away. Okay. We have other non-Muslims here amongst us, and I hope that they pick up on this statement and repeat it with us. It means one thing. I want you all to repeat in the English language, the language you all speak. There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is His messenger. There is no God but Allah, Muhammad is His messenger. There is no God but Allah, Muhammad is His messenger. Da'wah is our first goal. And I can't miss an opportunity of being exposed to a beautiful human being, to a beautiful brother or a sister who just missed saying Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah on this occasion of Mawlid, when we are celebrating the mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down to humanity. You know, brothers and sisters, what is the easiest address that you may get to? The easiest address when you travel, when you visit a friend, when you go in life, the easiest address you travel to, you know what it is? Your home. Your home is the easiest address. You can never get lost going back to your home. Now, dear brothers and sisters, we all want to go back to our homes. وَمَا مَوْطِنُ الْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا بِعَالَمٍ بِهِ الرَّاحُ تُجْلَى وَالْحَبِيبُ مُنَادِمُ بِحَضْرَةِ قُدْسِ اللَّهِ فِي عَالَمِ الْبَقَى فَتِلْكَ هِيَ الْأَوْطَانُ وَالْكَوْنُ خَادِمُ. Our homes are not on the face of this earth. Our homes are paradise. And the way is very clear. And with that I end. The way is very clear and very easy. You don't need to go to the internet and get a lot of instructions. It's very simple. Turn right, go straight. Turn right, go straight. It's very simple. It just takes a will. A will. So show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the guts you have. Compete for His sake. Show all strength you have in the field of competence, in the field of ibadah, to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as there is nothing that we're going to take with us out of this life that will benefit us except our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our love for the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And believe me, there is no way we can love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. There is no way. If you think you love Allah and you don't feel the love for the Messenger of Allah in your heart, you're mistaken. There is no way you can love Allah or worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely without turning to Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, you will be misguided and you are lured by the Satan. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grant us the honor of following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He plants in our heart the love for Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that motivates our yearning to Him, that motivates us to die for Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Wouldn't you wish to have been as I do? I wish and would that I were just the soil on which He walked sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Would that I were a glass He held sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or a cup He held to drink from, to touch His lips. Would that I was the urine that came out of Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, because it wasn't only pure, it was even a cure. Don't you want to wish to have been around Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Don't you miss Him? Missing Him is missing yourself. Missing Him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, He's your life. He is the tissue of our life sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And there is no way we can turn right or left. There is no way we can walk in this life. There is no way we can spend one single minute in this life without having His favors upon us sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Let's pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us enough love for Him. Let's pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the honor of visiting Him and the honor of seeing Him in our dreams and the honor of drinking from His basin on the Day of Judgment and the honor of His shafa'ah and ultimately the honor of His company in Al-Firdaus Al-A'la. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Our blessed teacher, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Yaqubi, for these blessed words. Jazakallah khair. May he, inshallah, he and we benefit of them eternally, inshallah, in both worlds, in the life of this world and in the world soon to come, fi dunya wal akhirah. Bi rahmatika ya Allah.